There's a group of people that want to have that one-on-one conversation with the trusted medical provider, their family members, to just hear more about the experience, see more people getting it, and feel more comfortable with time. I have to remind myself as a doctor and a mom that as much as I think about coronavirus every day, that's not necessarily the most important thing on everyone's mind. And so,
At this time, we know that COVID-19 is a serious illness. And so those would want people who were more likely to be resistant to the vaccine in general, did not think it was a serious illness and did not trust the government. And to many people, it kind of directs their decisions. One of the things that we know is that it would be important to have people go to sources or the sources to come to them to give them the right information.
You know, this is a very concerning trend that we're seeing, Ellison. Like you said,
what do you think about that? What do you think about the confusion it may lead to? What's your kind of advice to people on how to handle this? And do you think it ultimately could encourage more people to get vaccinated?
Savannah, this is something that has been long anticipated. We've been mixing and matching vaccines in other countries. Now the data pans out here in the U.S. to show that there is a 76-fold increase with mixing and matching.
Yeah, the FDA didn't make any direct authorizations, but they did say their research does show if you've been vaccinated with Johnson & Johnson, getting one of those mRNA vaccines, a Pfizer or Moderna, could actually help increase your antibody. One
of the complaints of some over mandates is the idea that government is telling people what they can do with their bodies. Does it at all make you uncomfortable, the idea? There will be molested.